argument with a couple of people here, and we're all debating about the music industry. Ziza Wakabi, Shiba is the next best thing. There is too much going on. And the only thing I actually noticed is how bad I miss the 90s. I miss the time when music was really music. I miss the times when Peter Sematimba would decide to do a hit and you would actually know that I'm going to listen to that hit forever and ever, never get tired. I miss Prim and Proper. I miss good music generally, but anyway, you know what? By the time in Uganda we can sit down and you're like, oh, Wakabi wa phases abafananze, but na imba si chitegera, but hey. It is the art of the game. Some people know how to play it, some people know how to deal it, and some people just stumble upon it. My name is Sina. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Let's guess what's happening in the celebrity world. Okay, so Jeff Chewa came out, he made a statement that it kind of didn't tickle my fancy because, okay, maybe this is the part where I'm being biased, but hey, he came out and he said, look here, Shiba is going to be, no, actually, word for word, quote for quote, he said, Shiba Karungi is far better than Radio and Weasel and will forever be much, much better than her, than he, than them. Good Lord, what is wrong with me? So, after that, I was like, say what now? Is this a Shiba versus Radio and Weasel situation? I was like, okay, why does he say this? It's like, wait for her concert, it's going to fill up arenas, blah, blah, blah. And I'm sitting there and I'm like, is this war of who you are managing now or something? I don't get it, because one thing is true. Shiba has worked so hard to get where she's at, honestly speaking. The only reason I give Shiba audience, the only reason I can respect her hustle and her game is the fact that the only thing she has in this world is her confidence. She has the confidence in whatever it is that she's doing. Whether it is to dance badly, she will do it confidently. Whether it's wearing horrible makeup, she'll do it confidently. Singing horrible lines, singing good songs, bad songs, you name it, being slutty on stage, she does it with a certain edge of confidence. That's the thing I like about her. It will push her places, very many places. It is pushing her places. Now, on the other hand, when we look at Radio and Weasel, first of all, I think the only reason that Radio and Weasel were a success in UG, one, I know people hate to say this, but one is because they came out from the Mayanja side of the family. Yeah, I'm going to put it there. I know they're going to stand there and be like, how? We've worked hard for them where we are. No. One of the reasons why your success is because, Radio, you are around the Mayanjas for way too long. Weasel, you are a Mayanja. Now, when you get that drive, that zeal, coupled together with a great voice from Radio, it all comes together so well. It balances out the entire equation. Now, pitching these two against each other, Radio Weasel versus Shiba Karungi. I'm sitting there and I'm like, look here, Jeff, talking about Kunsiruwaza. And as a listener, I'm going to sit here and say, okay, yes, Shiba is going to fill out concerts. She's going to sell out arenas for one reason. She has availed herself. She has made sure to do the kind of music that Ugandans will love and understand. And on top of that, she has used the oldest trick in the book. Come on, she's a woman. Her body. She has decided to walk around butt naked for the rest of the world to see. Lost a whole ton of weight. If you ask me, I think I liked Shiba when she was still chubby. She looked much better. But she lost a ton of weight, decided to walk around butt naked on stage, off stage. You name it, she became a rascal. And the Ugandans were like, we have our very own Rihanna. That is what is going to sell out her concert and sell out her arenas. And not forgetting, she's very tenacious. Now, if you ask me about Radio and Weasel, okay, the reason why we don't give two beats about Radio and Weasel anymore is one, by now, guys, Gabi, Tetusawala Chile, Katri no Chogera, Radio and Weasel, you are extremely bad mannered. Muemula, Muvuma, Enjoy Munwa Ninji, but you can sing. So if Jeff Chewa comes out and he pitches Shiba against you, I feel like that's the biggest disrespect that there ever can be. This is a moment where I would sit down, if I was ready, and lose and be like, two men being put against one chick who has only been here how long? Okay, she's been around for too long, but damn, that's shade, according to me. But let's wait and see how this all folds out. Jennifer, I don't have words, baby! I don't! I saw this photo of her and I was like, Jennifer Musisi, what's going on? And then Ugandans, you still have the... You, kanira desire luzinda. After I saw this, I was like, I'm a chick. And it's okay for me in a no-homo situation to be like, damn, this woman looks good. How can we even look at Desire Luzinda? First of all, Desire Luzinda got butt, what are they called? Butt fillers, thigh fillers, leg fillers, cheek fillers. She has Botox. She is all plastic in every type of corner. They have put it in, taken it out, put it back and taken it out again. She is what we call a used up body. You look at people like Anita Fabiola, really? Ugandans still have the time to go on social media once she posts a photo and you're like, oh my goodness, girl, you're fine. She looks like she has to first go to a bucket of yellow paint every morning. It's like her life, she just wakes up and she's like, guys, I need that spray tan again. Thank you for the shade. Now I can step out. You look at people like Winnie Mwaji. Do I need to remind you what Winnie Mwaji's thighs look like? Cellulite all over the place. And you leave all these people at the forefront and you forget a woman this dope. And on top of that, she's educated. Did I mention all these people we're talking about are very not educated? As in, this chick would actually walk into the Don's office to get a PhD. She would walk in and come out with her PhD. Immediately, 15 seconds. And she doesn't have to do all the work that these girls put in. I swear to all the women out there, if you know your man was lined up in that car photo with Jennifer Musisi and he was not bothered, then we have a problem. Like, Houston, there is a problem. If any man in their right mind ever stands behind Jennifer Musisi and doesn't look like this guy in the red shirt, you know you have a problem. Like, for crying out loud, do you say the expression? Like, I'm the one. Just know, whoever is standing behind Jennifer Musisi is having a great old time, and I hope he's a man, God. So, Maurice Kirya and his brother Vampino are finally doing a collaboration together. Wow! My thoughts? Maurice, Sibategera, this is too much. You cannot be this slow. Like, if you thought about it a long time ago, first of all, let me give you the specs of why I am very confused by this entire thing. Okay, it's not confusing me. I'm just asking why it never happened sooner. Like, one. Maurice, you yourself are still a struggling artist. I will get back to that later. But your brother has been an upcoming artist for quite a long time. Even when he was with Benon and Vampos, he was still the Vampos that we didn't quite understand. He was struggling. Now, as for you, Maurice, wagenda no demo music haba na Uganda gwebata tegera simanya moyo. Yes, we appreciate the fact that you came out, you had a soulful voice, you could sing. Half of the time, Ugandans are just like, But you stuck yourself there. I still think you're not that big of a success in Uganda. Elsewhere, maybe they understand the music. But Uganda, you're still also upcoming. You're struggling on Ugandan soil. And you stuck there and left us to deal with people like Maru, Michael Ross. Those are the guys who did R&B in Uganda. If you had just skipped out of Moyo and came to R&B, then pulled your brother Vampos and told him to stop coughing instead. Did I say coughing? Saba, the last time I heard he was on over the set of Mad Max over something. But all of you are actually stuck in alternate. It's like you're bouncing through a wormhole. Nobody knows which way they are going to come out from. You don't know which part of the universe you're supposed to be holding, but you're all there like, I'm just saying, like, for real, you should have done this a long time ago, but anyway. Am I allowed to say what Dankana? Anyway, it's been a good day here, crazy and fun filled as always. Don't forget, at TinaVS1 is my Twitter handle, or you can catch me on Facebook. Yes, that's the Scoop and Scoop page, or better yet, the Urban TV Facebook page. For all of you, I know Rugamba, Bagalo Kumbu, Lila Bagalo Kumbuma, Chona Chechiri. Find me on these forums. For now, it's been a good time. Oh, and by the way, big shout out to everybody who wished me a very happy birthday. It wasn't. Yeah, thank you. Could you recall? I'm out. Peace. Bye.